How many genders are there? 3, 4, 0, 23.14. The correct answer is 2. The myth that gender is a choice has been spread by the left in order to abuse children and deny sex differences. Sex is defined as the physical genitalia a person has, which is always either a penis or a vagina, which results in a change in a person's strengths, personality and interests. Men are best in positions of power, and women are best in the house being dominated by a male figure. 100 years ago, this would widely be considered the norm, but recently, progressive moves have sought to remove women's choices. Girls are now being told that they can do anything a boy can do, and they're even being allowed to in the leftist-run educational establishments of America. This experimentation of equal opportunities by feminists is nothing more than abuse of children for the benefit of leftist elites. The rights of women have still increased hugely, with them having more freedom than ever before. And this is all thanks to men who gave up their privileges to give women more status. Yet ungrateful feminists want to harm modern men by selfishly asking for more rights, such as wanting to be safe from rape and sexual abuse. Women today should all be thanking men for what they have done. Feminist women today often act responsible for the women who asked for and got more rights many years ago, that they have nothing to do with them. Today comes a new threat to women. People who think they can choose their gender, and the leftist establishments letting this happen. Parents are abusing children by not forcibly assigning them a gender, and not forcibly operating on genitals to make assigning a gender easier for society. The idea that someone can choose a gender to match their personality is in direct denialism that the two different genders have different personalities. This experimentation on children is nothing but child abuse. This harms women by giving them more freedoms and allowing them to have opportunities only men should. Increasingly, we are seeing spaces that should be separated by gender be used for people who are pretending to be that gender. We've even seen these become completely gender unsegregated. This is allowing women to be raped by men who pretend to be women. And yet the feminists who claim to want to stop rape are often the ones saying that we shouldn't have people checking the genitalia of everyone who wants to access women-only spaces. In fact, these leftist elites only care about finding problems with society for money rather than stopping rape by blaming rapists for rape and not themselves. Some people have gone a step further and said you can choose to be any gender you like, and if you claim to identify as president, it is oppressive not to make you president. This just shows how everyone who pretends to be a gender, they aren't purely want an easier, more privileged life and an elevated social standing. If the discrimination statistics were true, why would people be choosing to be another gender? There are only two genders. And remember, if you ever see someone who looks like a man entering a women's bathroom, make sure you harass them and forcibly enter all the cubicles until you find the suspected man and beat him up. This has been Dinner Murderer for Prager University.
If you would like to make a tax-deductible donation to Prager University, please put all your money under a magnifying glass in direct sunlight. Thank you.